Hallie Laura, you are watching why Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are happy to engage in public displays of affection but William and Kate don't. Prince Harry and his actress girlfriend delighted fans when they revealed their romance to the world at the Invictus Games. Prince Harry and US girlfriend Meghan Markle finally took their romance public late last month following a year of dating. First, the pair confidently walked hand in hand into the Invictus Games, the international multi-sport Paralympic event he founded, wheelchair tennis finals. Then they were seen cuddling up to each other at the closing games ceremony, with the royal even pictured planting a tender kiss on the 36-year-old suit's star's cheek. In contrast, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are rarely, if ever, openly affectionate when carrying out their public engagements, which prompts the question, is there a royal rule on refraining from PDAs? There isn't an official protocol to prevent them from doing so, but they apparently choose not to in order to maintain their professionalism. The likely reasoning is more that while traveling on a tour such as the India trip, technically the couple are working representatives of British monarchy, the founder of Beaumont Etiquette, Micah Meyer told People. The couple are likely to show very little PDA, if any, to remain professional during their designated roles abroad. It's also understood that the younger royals are required to follow the Queen's example. The Queen is rarely seen holding Prince Philip's hand while they are on public engagements. Robin Kermode, body language expert and founder of communications coaching company Zone2.co.uk, explains Kate and William are taking cues from the Queen. The Queen rarely holds hands with her husband in public and this seems to have set an unwritten precedent for the other royals, Robin notes. It is very clear that William and Kate are emotionally close, however, they do not seem to feel the need to prove their love, particularly when on official state business, he also observed. Prince Harry and Meghan's first public display of affection also came at the Invictus Games, a far more casual event than others, and Harry technically wasn't working when they were seen kissing. While the Duke and Duchess don't necessarily engage in PDAs while enjoying more low-key events like Wimbledon, they're certainly a lot more relaxed than they would be at a public engagement. At the 2012 Olympic Games, for example, the casually dressed pair were pictured sharing a hug. Of course, it could also be that Kate and Will have been together for a long time now and don't feel the need for PDAs. Harry and Meghan are still in the honeymoon period and look positively smitten with one another. Finally, Harry is only sixth in line to the throne after the birth of the next royal baby, while Prince William is the heir to the throne. This is why Prince Harry and Meghan Markle hold hands but the Duke and Duchess won't. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are rarely seen holding hands or kissing in public unlike Harry and Meghan. What are the rules? When you're a member of the royal family, there are certain protocols you're expected to stick to. Monopoly is banned. Unmarried women can't wear tiaras and PDAs are frowned upon according to these unwritten rules. Public displays of affection are considered uncouth, which is why you won't see Duchess Kate Middleton and Prince William holding hands or kissing on a public engagement. But you may have noticed that Meghan Markle and Prince Harry seemed very cozy at the Invictus Games in Toronto last month, despite also having the eyes of the world on them. So why do the two brothers play by different rules? Firstly, Meghan and Harry were free to be intimate at the games because they weren't officially at work. Because Meghan isn't a member of the royal family, she wasn't attending the Invictus Games for business reasons. When Harry opened the games and met with officials, he was there in a business capacity. But when he later watched the games with his girlfriend, he was off duty and therefore could act as he pleased. It was the first time the couple had appeared together in public and Harry marked the occasion by planting a kiss on his girlfriend's face, much to the delight of those watching. Moreover, there isn't a ban on PDA for royals. It's more of a question of following the Queen's example, as she rarely held Prince Philip's hand on public engagements. And this has become an unwritten precedent for the other royals, Robin Kermode, body language expert. It is very clear that William and Kate are emotionally close, however, they do not seem to feel the need to prove their love, particularly when on official state business, he added. They come across as a strong, independent couple and while they are always on show, they do not feel the need to show their love for each other to the world. Whereas Harry and Meghan are in a much newer relationship, making it hardly surprising that they seem so loved up. This article originally appeared on The Sun and has been republished with permission. Thank you for watching. Please share video and subscribe my channel for more video.